Building your first discrete event simulation model in Python can be hard. For the last 17 years, I've worked on simulation projects tackling some of the toughest challenges in healthcare, from emergency departments to stroke care to delayed discharges. And in this series of videos, I'll share with you some tips to reduce the pain of getting your first simulation model up and running. In this first video, we'll look at sampling from statistical distributions in Python. I'm going to guide you through four aspects of sampling relevant for discrete event simulation, from creating high quality pseudo-random number generators, generating samples from well-known distributions such as the exponential, how do we spawn multiple non-overlapping streams of random numbers, and then finally, how do we bring these ingredients together and use object-oriented programming techniques to set these distributions up for simulation models. So for any type of modeling and simulation in Python, I recommend you make use of the numpy.random namespace. This is because it provides a variety of efficiently implemented statistical distributions. And also what I really like is it provides an object-oriented interface into pseudo-random number streams. More on what that means later in the video. So let's create an instance of a random number generator here in Python. So we're going to use NumPy. I'm going to call from the random namespace the default RNG method. That returns a NumPy random number generator. And in fact, what it's done is it's created an instance of PCG64, which you don't need to know the details of internally. But what I can say is it's a very, very high quality random number generator. That has a very long period, so it has a very large number of random numbers before it begins again, and it can support a very large number of random streams, which suits discrete event simulation very well indeed. So if we wanted to use that for sampling, we can follow this procedure here, where all we need to do is create a random number generator, select the statistical distribution we would like to sample from, pass in how many samples we would like to create, and then store the result in an appropriately named variable. So for example, if I wanted to sample from the normal distribution, I could create an instance of a random number generator. And here I've also passed in a seed, 42, and this allows me to always get the same samples from the random number generator. Then I'm going to, from the RNG object that I've returned, I'm going to call the uniform method of that object, and I'm going to sample between the value 10 and for exclusive of 40s. And I'm going to return 1 million samples, and I'm going to store that in a variable called samples, and that's actually going to be a NumPy array that is returned. Then I've got a function, my own function distribution plot, which is hidden a little bit higher up in the notebook, that's just going to return a matplotlib plot for us to view that. So we've just generated 1 million samples, and we can see that that falls between 10 and 40. And it's as simple as that. If we wanted to repeat that, but instead use the exponential distribution, instead of calling the uniform method, we would call the exponential method. We would pass in this case, the scale parameter of the exponential distribution, which is 12 in this example. We're again going to return 1 million samples from that, and we're going to plot at the same time. Okay, and there's our classic exponential distribution. And we could do something similar for normal and so on, the sky is the limit. Take a look at the NumPy documentation online to view all of the distributions that you could generate with the NumPy random namespace. Now, in these cases, what we were doing was generating many samples in one go. In a typical discrete event simulation, actually what you'll be doing is generating only a single value at a time, because you'll be modeling some sort of process. So in that case, what you might do is omit the size parameter. So here we're going to sample from the normal distribution, and we're just going to pass in the location and scale and omit size. That's going to return a value called sample, which is just a float. And we're going to just prove that by printing out the value and the type of that variable as well. And you can see we've sampled 26.5 and it's returned a float. Now, why didn't I set the size to 1? Why did I omit it? Well, you could set the size to 1 if you wanted to, but a NumPy array would be returned if you did that. So if we just run this code here, where you can see we set the size to 1, what's happened is when we print out sample in this case, you can see that 26.5 is enclosed in square brackets, which means it is a NumPy array that has been returned. So to access that individual scalar value, we've needed to use array notation here and access element 1 of that NumPy array. So in general, if you're looking to sample an individual value, it makes more sense to omit that rather than include it. Now, in each of these examples, I've been using seeds, and seeds are useful to help us get repeatable results. That reduces the headache of debugging your code, and it also makes sure that your results are repeatable when you rerun them at a later date. In discrete event simulation, we want to have multiple random number generators, one for each of the sampling processes that we've included in the simulation model. So ideally, what we'd like to be able to do is issue a single seed and be able to create high quality random number streams that don't overlap. So we can do that in NumPy using seed sequence. So in this example here, I'm going to create two random number generators, one, for example, representing an arrival process and the another representing a service process, from a single user seed here, which I'm going to set to 1. Now, one of the great things about seed sequence is that this can be a low quality seed. For example, it could just be the replication number that you're using in your simulation. And seed sequence takes care of the independence of streams for us. So here, what I do is I create an instance of a seed sequence. I pass in my user seed. The seed sequence object is returned, and I've called that seed sequence. I can then access the methods of that object. And there's a useful one called spawn, where I pass in the number of streams that I would like to create, in this case 2. And that returns a Python list, which contains high quality seeds that can be used by NumPy random number generators to create non-overlapping streams of random numbers. So once I've run this code, I can then go on and create the associated random number generators. So I'm going to create arrival underscore RNG here, which represents the arrival process. And I'm going to use array notation to access item 0 of that list, pass in the seed there. And then I'm going to do the same for the service distribution here. And then I can use those random number generators just as I had used before. But the difference is I've only had to specify one seed myself, and NumPy takes care of everything else for me. So we can bring all of these ingredients together in a kind of cool reusable framework for our simulation models now. What I recommend is that you make use of object-oriented programming techniques here. In fact, just a very basic technique of defining a class. So here, for example, I've defined an exponential class. And what this exponential distribution class does is it packages up the parameters of the exponential, in this case, just the mean, a random seed that I've specified or has been created from a seed sequence object, and the pseudo random number generator. So in the initializer of this class, I'm passing in the parameter of the exponential, the mean, and my random seed, and then creating an instance of a pseudo random number generator, which I'm storing within the member variable rand, and I'm storing the mean of that distribution. I've then defined a method called sample, which takes an optional parameter called size. In most cases in a discrete event, you'll just be sampling one value, so you would omit that when you called the method. And what that does is it makes use of the random number generator I've created and the stream of pseudo random numbers to sample from the exponential distribution using the mean that I passed in. So that's really cool if you want to quickly create parameters for your simulation model. So for example, imagine a model that's looking at an acute length of stay in a hospital and a rehabilitation length of stay. Following that, we can very quickly create an exponential distribution, pass in the parameters which are remembered, which are the mean of the distribution in this case. We can specify a random seed so we can get repeatable results. And then we could do that again for rehabilitation, but include a different mean value and a different random seed. And then we can call those independently in a kind of object orientated way. So for my acute length of stay, I would just call the sample method and I would return a sample of a length of stay for the acute stay. I could do that again and obtain a different value. And then I could do that independently for my rehabilitation length of stay. So now that we've learned about sampling using NumPy, we can build our first SimPy model. So check out the next video where we learn about generating arrivals to a system.